Ahun. Neled herain. Dan Carmenig, Aragorn. Nedim Dagor, hen Urir Othari.
We've all heard Legolas speaking Elvish in the Lord of the Rings franchise. I remember binge-watching the movies in one New Year's Eve night. For a few years, I always wondered if the language he's speaking is real, or is it just a random string of words. Today, I not only know that it is real, but I'm also going to teach you how to speak Elvish in 8 minutes. Now, of course, learning a language in just a few minutes is impossible. So, what exactly am I going to do? Well, I'm going to use mnemonics and show you how you can use associations to your advantage while teaching you the basics of Elvish. Now, there's more than one Elven language. The one I'm covering today is Sindarin, the one most commonly used in Tolkien's Lord of the Rings. The word Sindarin is itself derived from Quenya, the other popular Elven language in Tolkien's books. The writing system of Sindarin is called Tengwar. You've probably seen it while watching the movies. Now let's get into some sentences. Okay, so imagine you're meeting Legolas and you have to greet him somehow. So, the way you say hi in Sindarin is A. It's really easy to remember. The first thing you say is the first letter of the alphabet. The other thing you can say instead or after A is something that translates to well met, and it's Mae Govanen. Just imagine you're meeting Legolas in May, and then what sounds like Govanen? Maybe oven? So after meeting Legolas in May, you go to the oven together to bake something for dinner. Just picture it in your head. The more you focus on it, the easier it will be for you to remember it. Okay, so now that you're going to eat together, Legolas would probably want to know your name. He's probably going to ask you Mangi Engethling, which means what's your name? Now, the word Engeth means name. You'll just have to remember it because we're gonna use it in the next sentence. If you want to answer this question, just say I Engethling plus your name. Now, there pretty much aren't any modern names in Elvish, but that's part of the fun. You can create your own name in Sindarin. Just search the word corresponding to the meaning of your name in the dictionary. Or you can use just any cool sounding word you'll find. There will be a link to the dictionary in the description. So, if you want to introduce yourself, it's I Engethling and then your name. At this point, Legolas will probably ask you if you actually speak Elvish. So, when he asks you Pedileteleng, you can answer no, u, or yes, ma. There isn't one direct word for yes, but ma is really close. Now, if you want to say a bit or maybe, a really close word to that is nai, which literally means may it be. If you proceed with the conversation in Elvish and you don't understand something, you may say, sorry, I don't understand. Sorry in Sindarin is gohengongin. Remember the pronoun ngin? It means me or my. And the way you can remember gohengo is to imagine, for example, yourself going to get a henga tattoo with Legolas. Go for a henga tattoo, Legolas. Gohengongin, Legolas. Ukenyong. Ukenyong means I don't understand. Remember the u? It means no. So I do not understand is very easy to remember. Also, a quick side note here. Did you know that Tolkien was making languages when he was a child? It's incredible, because it was the languages that provoked him to create this incredible, rich fantasy world. As he wrote in a letter, the stories were made rather to provide a world for the languages than the reverse. So you can see that Tolkien really loved his constructed languages. Now, I also wanted to add that I'm not a master at pronouncing Sindarin, so if you actually can speak it, just let me know how to improve. Okay, getting back to your conversation with Legolas. Now, when you are getting henga tattoos and you see him in a bit of pain, you can ask him, Mangenki, how are you feeling? If he's all right, he can say Immayer. I'm fine. You can think of the pronoun im like being the English I'm, but really it just means me, myself, or I. Mayer means useful or good. You can remember it easily by imagining that Legolas loves May because in this month everything is beautiful and good. If he's not okay though, he would probably say im uvaer, I'm not fine. Remember the u? If you'd like to cheer him up, you can say don't worry, avaro naef. I always think of it as being something Alvaro Soler would say. Just imagine him having the hair of Legolas and cheering you up. Avaro naef, mellon. If Legolas appreciates your company, he may say thank you, len hangon. Now, if you say len hangon quickly, it sounds kinda like Lennon. So you can imagine John Lennon thanking you. Imagine. Get it? Okay, now that you know how to say thank you should also know how to say please. And although there isn't a single word to describe it, you can say angelning. You should actually connect the two first words while speaking, so it really would be angelning. We've already seen the word ning, and you can think of the angel part as something an angel would say. Okay, this is the end of your conversation with Legolas. You should probably say goodbye. And goodbye is galu. You can also be more formal, mysterious, or even vintage and say farewell, which is novaer. This is a really popular word. Novaer. So, that's all. You just had a conversation in Elvish. Epically. Alright, thank you for watching. Of course, I'm just scratching the surface with this video. You can learn Sindarin and speak it fluently. It's a real language. For now, I just hope that this video made you interested in the language and that now you have a better understanding of Tolkien's genius. And I can always do a part 2. Or, as an elf would say, part tat.